The manager of the National Theater in Westwood says that there indeed are at least a dozen people who faint or become ill during every showing.
For many people, The Exorcist is considered the scariest movie of all time. Many who believe this are the ones who got to experience the film when it first came out on December 26, 1973. Lines of moviegoers wrapped around cinemas in anticipation, and then the reviews and instances during some of the initial screenings created all-out madness. This was a film unlike any movie before, especially for your average Joe looking to get entertained for 2 hours on the weekend. The language was vile, scenes were, quote, sacrilegious, and the concept of demonic possession was alive and well. It barely missed the death sentence that is an X rating. A San Francisco man attacked the demon when it appeared on the big screen. One man fell, broke his jaw after fainting supposedly due to subliminal effects, and sued Warner Brothers. The publicity department made sure everyone in the world knew this film came from a true historical account of a real exorcism from 1949. Theaters handed out complimentary barf bags. Renowned evangelist Billy Graham denounced the film, saying, "The devil is in every frame of the film." Death threats were sent to little Linda Blair for her portrayal, accusing her of glorifying Satan. The production was supposedly cursed. 9 people somehow linked to the film died. The set in Georgetown burned down mysteriously, and somehow, Reagan's room was apparently not affected at all. Ellen Burstyn suffered a severe spinal injury. The film went over budget and over schedule, and director William Friedkin even had the set blessed by a priest. And with all this, the Catholic Church actually supported the film. The Exorcist became the first horror movie to ever receive an Academy Award nomination for Best Picture. But in order to truly understand The Exorcist, one must look at William Peter Blatty, the author of the original novel and writer of the Academy Award-winning script. After all, his name is the one above the title. Coming from a religious background, he went to Georgetown University as an English major, but also considered becoming a Jesuit priest due to his mother's strong religious beliefs. Instead, he ended up in Hollywood doing publicity for USC, ghost wrote a bestseller called Dear Teenager by Dear Abby, became a comic novelist, and then wrote comedic screenplays, including Blake Edwards' classic, A Shot in the Dark, starring Peter Sellers as Inspector Clouseau. One day, Blake Edwards met William Friedkin to direct a film, and Friedkin said he just couldn't do it. The script was garbage. William Peter Blatty wrote that script. Secretly, Blatty agreed, and he never forgot that Friedkin was the only one to tell him and Edwards the truth, that it was a pile of trash. But Blatty also had something else he wanted to write, something other than comedy. While at Georgetown, he had heard of an exorcism of a young boy. On August 20th, 1949, an article about the possession appears on the front cover of the Washington Post. There were claims of, quote, mysterious rappings in the walls of their home, radical personality changes, words appearing on his chest, profanity, screaming, blasphemy, shouting Latin phrases, bloody scratches appearing on his arms, projectile vomiting, inhuman feats of strength, objects flying around the house, and other inexplicable events, including levitation. Blatty wanted to write about it as a nonfiction piece originally, but the family of the boy wanted no publicity. Instead, he turned to fiction. He modeled the mother Chris McNeil after his friend Shirley MacLaine, and Father Karras after himself. Both Blatty and Karras had questions of faith after their mothers had passed. But the first drafts of the novel were drastically different. It centered around a boy murdering someone. The mother, knowing her son was the killer, decides to bring in psychiatrists who will likely explain the boy to be insane and therefore cannot be punished harshly. When that fails, the mother decides to call in the Catholic Church, convincing everyone a demon possessed the child and therefore couldn't be found guilty. It was a far cry from what The Exorcist eventually became. Blatty got a $10,000 advance from Bantam Books after a chance encounter with the editor-in-chief during a New Year's Eve party. He completed the book in 9 months, averaging 14 to 18-hour days. His friend Shirley MacLaine was interested in playing the role, but they could never agree on a deal. Blatty wanted to produce the film. And even though the film was optioned, the book was not a success to start. It was exactly the opposite. Bookstores were returning the novel by the box load to publishers. There was simply no interest. And then something happened. Something unexpected. Something that changed William Peter Blatty's life forever. Something that would change the face of horror forever.